Paul Wazelsteiner, you're the Chief Executive Director of the Bitcoin Cash Association. First question, what is that?
So we are a non-profit association that has the sole purpose of increasing adoption of Bitcoin Cash. So Bitcoin Cash for us is the best chance to change the entire world for the better and provide financial freedom for everybody.
Yeah, we have a lot of enthusiastic Bitcoin Cash lovers around here today. Is there a way that the foundation gets funded out of the system itself, so that every time a percentage of the mining comes in there, or do you have to basically ask all the people for money?
So yeah, we Bitcoin Cash doesn't work like Dash, so we don't take any tax or subsidy from the actual mining reward or anything like that. We just we operate off of donations from the community, sponsorships from major players in the industry, and potential other revenue streams as well. I think that's an important way of doing it, because then it's just it's free choice.
Free choice. Okay. What do you do? What kind of activities do you have here, except for being a judge here at the first European hackathon, the Bitcoin Cash hackathon?
So yeah, we try and do as much as possible. So we sponsor every single Bitcoin Cash meetup around the world. We are working on conferences. We create educational videos, websites, content, creative media that people can go and use freely. Anything that can increase adoption of Bitcoin Cash, that's what we're going to go.
How many people work there?
At the moment, we've got four staff, so not a huge amount, but we're trying to, remain lean and put as much.
You're doing a good job in that. And what's your yearly budget in Bitcoin Cash to spend?
It kind of fluctuates quite significantly. Just obviously, the bear market has had a big impact on that. Yeah. So obviously, the lower the price, the more we have to spend in Bitcoin Cash value.
Yeah.
I wouldn't like to say at the moment. It kind of changes on almost daily.
Yeah, yeah. But I mean, you're very transparent. So I mean, sure. Do you spend 1,000 Bitcoin Cash a year, or do you spend 2,000 Bitcoin Cash a year?
So in terms of BCH, I honestly couldn't say right now. In terms of like fiat value, it would be somewhere between 500,000 to €1 million.
Okay. So small amounts of money. So how's Bitcoin Cash doing in your opinion in this bear market? In this bear market, of which Bitcoin Cash also got her fair share.
Yeah, I mean, if you ignore the price, which you should, honestly, in a bear market, you can see things like this where you get 100, 200 people turn up to an event and, they've got their heads down, they're working hard to build amazing things. I think that shows what is actually happening. There's a fertile ground that when things pick up again and new users start pouring in, Bitcoin Cash is going to be in a very, very strong position to actually...
Which everybody says, right? In the bear market, we're making everything more professional, we're making the products better, we're getting educated. That's what everybody does. But what about specific about Bitcoin Cash?
Sure. I mean, that's a good question, I must say. There is a difference, though. For example, on Bitcoin Core, what other people may call Bitcoin, they don't have the same utility that Bitcoin Cash does, because Bitcoin Cash offers a basis where it works every single time. A transaction costs less than a cent, so developing new products is actually very, very cheap and easy to do. It's reliable, and you don't necessarily have this on other chains, because they may already be congested, even in a bear market where there's not so many users.
Yeah, but I mean, transaction costs on the Bitcoin main is also going down, etc. But we'll see when everything goes up and the amount of volume goes up in the application. Did you already see interesting applications on Bitcoin Cash? Real usage?
Sure, yeah. I mean, even just here, there's been interesting applications. So,
In the last year, what's your number one application which Bitcoin Cash is used for? So now you have about 5 more seconds to think before you have to answer that question.
Okay, sure. So I would say Money Button. Money Button actually makes making a payment on the internet extremely simple. So both if you're a user or if you're the person accepting the payment, it makes it easier than signing up for a PayPal account or making a payment with PayPal. It's literally the click of a button, and anyone that installs Money Button on any web page, can accept money. This is a game changer, in my opinion. And it can be tiny amounts, it can be a cent. You could never do that with PayPal. I think this is going to have a big impact.
Okay, so that's a cool one. So, did you see the different teams? You've looked at it. What's your favorite at the moment? In 2 hours, you have to come up with a formal judgment?
So, I haven't had time to see every single project yet. There's a couple that I do like in particular. There's one which is it's called Pop. proof of picture. Yeah. So you put a picture on the blockchain, or you put a hash of a picture on the blockchain.
I think so too, yeah.
Yeah, and so that proves that that picture existed at a certain time. Yeah. And it has interesting applications. I've discussed this before with people, that you could prove that you were the person to have this photo first if other people were using this technology.
Yeah. In general, with documents, you can do everything like that, right? But that's one application they have here.
Yeah, and then another one, I know a team were working on a tool for Money Button. So one, it's not an issue with Money Button, but let's say a limitation of it is that you have to have a website to put the Money Button on. And they've developed a system where you don't need to have a website. You just go to their website, put in your name, and then you can use that link to actually accept a payment without having your own website.
So that's really cool. Yeah, yeah. It makes it even easier. Okay. So good luck with Bitcoin Cash, and the jury will see who the winner is.
Did you like this video? There's more where this came from. Subscribe and click the bell to get notified about our new videos.